بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to another episode of our series السفرة الكرام, تجويد, the art of reciting the Quran. In a very beautiful hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم drew forth a parable, drew forth an image describing for us the status of the Quran. It's a very beautiful parable here. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says that Allah has set forth an example, a mathal, a parable. There is a road which leads straight to the destination. It leads to where you want to go. However, on either side of the road, there is a wall. And in this wall, there are doors with curtains hanging. Curtains hanging from these doors. From the remote end of the road, in other words, from the front of the road, there is a voice that is calling out, "Proceed, come forth, come straight, and don't turn to any side." And whenever someone tries to lift up the curtain, then another voice calls, but this voice calls from above. And that voice says, beware, careful, don't lift the curtain or else you will be lured inside. Don't lift the curtain or else you will fall through into the door. This is the example of a straight path, and it has walls on either side. At the front of the straight path, there is a voice that calls you, guiding you where to go. You know where the path is. And there are curtains hanging to try to divert you. When you try to divert into these curtains, then a voice calls out from above and it warns you, don't do so, careful. If you open this door, you will fall into it. Then the Prophet ﷺ explained, what is this? He said, the straight path is Islam. This is Islam. The voice that calls from the end of the road is the Quran. It is the Quran that guides you in your life. It will show you the Sirat al-Mustaqim. It will show you the path to Jannah. And the walls are the hudud of Allah. The walls are the limits that Allah has set. This is allowed and this is not allowed. So whoever transgresses from what is allowed into what is not allowed, he has gone into one of these curtains. And the heart, or the voice that calls from above, this is the monitor that Allah has placed in the heart of every believer. In English, we call it a conscience. Every single mu'min, when he does something wrong, he knows he's doing something wrong. And he feels guilty for it. This is that conscience. This is the heart. This is the monitor that Allah has placed in the heart of every believer. Beautiful parable here, showing us the status and the blessedness of this holy book of Islam, the book of the Quran, the speech of Allah. If we wish to be guided, all we have to do is to read it, listen to it, and obey it, and we will be guided to the straight path to Jannah. Today's topic of Tajweed involves the solar and lunar letters, al-huruf al-shamsiyya wal-huruf al-qamariyya. Now you will ask, what has astronomy got to do with Tajweed? Absolutely nothing. However, there are certain letters, that are called solar letters and others are called lunar letters. Why and what is the purpose of this? Well, let us look at the Arabic words and you will understand what I'm talking about. Notice when I say ash-shams, which is the Arabic word for sun, where is the lam? Silent. Silent. It's not pronounced, right? Ash-shams. However, when I say al-qamar, the Arabic word for moon, can you hear the lam?
Yes.
This is exactly what the letters that are solar and lunar are. Okay, there's nothing to do with the sun and moon, but it's just that the Arabic word for ash-shams, the lam is silent, and the Arabic word for al-qamar, the lam is not silent. Therefore, there are a number of letters in the Arabic language that when this alif-lam, in English we call it the participle, the definite participle, it makes something one. Rajul, it makes something unique. Rajul means a man. Ar-rajul means the man, a particular specific man. So this alif lam is called the definite participle. When it occurs in any noun, then you look at the first letter of that noun. If the first letter is from the letters of the sun, you call it al-huruf al-shamsiyya, this means that the lam will be what?
Silent.
And if the first word of that noun is of the letters of the moon, then the lam will be pronounced. Okay. Now there is a simple phrase that the scholars have derived for the qamari letters, and anything that's not in this phrase, any letter that's not in this phrase, you can consider it to be a solar letter. Okay. It's just hamza, ba, ghain, ha, jim, كاف واو خاء فاء عين قاف ياء ميم and ها. And the scholars have mixed them all up to get this phrase here, إبغي حجك وخف عقيمه. Okay, it doesn't mean anything. It's just that you're supposed to say this over and over again until you memorize the qamari or the solar letters. Okay, notice that this only applies to the alif lam. It doesn't mean that any lam that occurs before any of these letters will be silent. No, only the alif lam that occurs before them, the alif lam participle, only this lam, not any lam in the Quran, only this particular lam, it will be considered to be silent. So you have to memorize this. This is absolutely essential that you memorize these letters, because if you don't memorize them, you're going to make mistakes in when to make the lam silent and when to pronounce it. Once you memorize it, anything not on this list is considered to be of the solar letters. And actually, alhamdulillah, most of the Muslims, when they start learning to recite the Quran, they are taught this from a very early age, so they know it. And after a while, it becomes second nature. It is something which is ingrained in a person who learns how to read Arabic. So alhamdulillah, this is not a difficult rule. This is a very easy one. And we'll try to implement it along with all of our previous rules as well. Remember, we're going to build from our episodes. So we'll try to implement this along with the other rules in reciting Surah Al-Shams, if you will recite along with me. Surah Al-Shams wa Shamsi wa Duhaha, which is Surah number 91 in the Quran. Okay, Surah number 91.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
والشمس وضحاها.
والشمس وضحاها.
Okay, what is the alif lam here? Obviously, from the very word itself, solar. And in fact, the sun itself is والشمس. Okay.
والقمر إذا تلاها.
والقمر إذا تلاها.
Okay, we have here which word now? القمر. So again, we have the moon, the lunar letter, which is the قاف over here. So we pronounce the lam. Okay, notice here now the قَمَرَ. Okay, the قَاف here, we find it to be heavy. Remember, we covered this before. What type of letter is قَاف?
Heavy.
A heavy letter. It is of the letters of تَفْخِيم. Therefore, when we say قَامَ, القمر, we notice there's a difference between the فَتْحَ of the قَاف and the فَتْحَ of the ميم. The فَتْحَ of the قَاف is heavier because the قَاف is of the letters of تَفْخِيم. We did this in an earlier episode. We don't say وَالْقَمَرِ وَالْقَامَ وَالْقَامَرِ. Okay?
وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا.
وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا.
Okay, we have النهار. Is noon one of the قمري letters? Look over here. Do we see a noon?
No.
No. Therefore, we pronounce it. And we consider it to be silent. Therefore, how do we pronounce it? والنهار. We didn't say والنهار. We dropped the lam because it is a solar letter.
والليل إذا يغشاها.
والليل إذا يغشاها.
Okay, in this case, the lam of the al-layl, it has a shadda on it, so some of you might get confused, but it is in fact the alif lam participle followed by the word layl. But since it is a lam in and of itself, then you put a shadda on it and you pronounce it. So you pronounce the lam immediately. وَالْلَيْلِ. Okay.
وَالسَّمَاءِ وَمَا بَنَاهَا.
وَالسَّمَاءِ وَمَا بَنَاهَا.
Okay, what is it over here?
Solar.
The solar letter. Because the scene is not of the lunar letters. Therefore, we drop the lam and we say وَالسَّمَاءِ.
والأرض وما طحاها.
والأرض وما طحاها.
Okay, in الأرض, what letter are we looking at?
Lunar.
The lunar letter, which is a hamza, the first of our lunar letters here. The first of our lunar letters is a hamza. Okay, so we have والأرض. We pronounce the لام.
ونفس وما سواها.
ونفس وما سواها.
فألهمها فجورها وتقواها.
فألهمها فجورها وتقواها.
قد أفلح من زكاها.
قد أفلح من زكاها.
Okay, what rule of tajweed did we study in تقواها and قد أفلح and قد خاب؟
القلقلة.
Very good. We have here a silent قاف in the تقواها. What level of قلقلة will this be?
It's the weakest.
It's the weakest level. Yes. It's the weakest because it occurs in the middle of
a word.
Okay. قد أفلح. What type of قلقلة would be a little bit higher than that because it occurs at the end of a word. And similar with وقد خاب من دساها. Notice here the خاب and دساها. Once again, notice the تفخيم and the ترقيق on the ألفs. خاب. Notice the ألف how heavy it is. Why? Because the خاء is of the letters of تفخيم or heaviness. And دساها light. It's the alif here is light because the seen is not of the heavy letters.
كذبت ثمود بطغواها.
كذبت ثمود بطغواها.
إذ انبعث أشقاها.
إذ انبعث أشقاها.
Once again in the أشقاها we have the heavy and the light versus in طغواها we only had it light.
فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها.
فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها.
فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم.
Okay, I ran out of breath there. What should I do now?
Go back again.
Go back to a few letters or a few words and then start again. So here in a good case is فدمدم. So we say, I stopped here, ربهم. So I'll go back to, rewind if you like to, فدمدم.
فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها.
I want you all to stop there as well, ربهم, and then go back, فدمدم. Okay.
فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم. فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها.
ولا يخاف عقباها.
ولا يخاف عقباها.
Okay, so in today's episode, we did a very simple and easy rule, and that is the solar and lunar letters. The solar letters are those letters which, when they occur after the alif lam participle, then you will drop the lam sound and immediately join the alif to the solar letter. And the lunar letters are the exact opposite, that when they occur after the alif lam, you will say that letter along with the lam sound. And this is a rule, as I said, alhamdulillah, most of the Muslims know this. This brings us to the conclusion of today's episode. Inshallah, we hope to see you in our next episode. Until then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.